The term British Empire was only really used by the elites before 1880. If you asked the average Brit about the British Empire before then, they would most likely not know what you was on about, or maybe just think you're referring to the United Kingdom itself. In contemporary times, the British Empire was not seen like other empires, such as the Roman one. This is because the British Empire was never built on conquest, and never had an emperor or empress. Queen Victoria only later adopting the title to better fit into Indian culture. The 13 colonies, Canada, Australia and New Zealand, were all just places that the British people migrated to. They didn't go to conquer or subjugate, but instead just to seek a better life. What was later referred to as the British Empire was built mostly by private individuals, not by command. The state rarely ever got involved in this, but when they did, it was when people asked for permission to settle or to go and set up trade monopolies in places around the world. These were seen as commercial ventures to the government, not as conquests. This is not to say that conquests didn't happen, because they did, but they were rare. These places were also conquered only to protect trade and private venture, such as in the case of Egypt. The East India Trading Company, for example, asked for permission to set up a trade monopoly in Mirage. And over time, this company simply expanded on its own. It's only when the East India Trading Company asked the Crown to intercede and govern the Raj that the British Empire could be considered a true empire. Before then, it was just seen as commercial ventures and people seeking better lives. It was really an empire by accident. It was just independent British people going off into the world and doing their own thing. Therefore, it is a myth that we're in decline. What has really changed? We never set out to make a Roman imperial style empire. The only thing that's changed is that the places our forefathers went have now grown into their own independent and sovereign nations that can stand on their own two feet. All the trading monopolies have fallen, but in their place westernising and spreading our culture across the globe, such as in India or in the African nations. This, I would argue, is progression, not decline. It could conversely be argued that we have declined as an industrial power. And this is partly true. As the birthplace of the Industrial Revolution, you might think that the UK would be more competitive. But not really. It's just that we spread the Industrial Revolution around the world. As standard of living has risen in the UK, such as workers' rights, this is yet to happen in nations like China or Indonesia, where they can still milk their citizens like cattle. The UK is still a top manufacturing nation to this day, ranked around 9th depending on how you calculate things. This is great considering its small size, great workers' rights, and major focus on finance instead of manufacturing. And even better, the manufacturing industries in the Kansuk nations and the USA are hyper-competitive and specialised in things that cannot be easily replicated in other nations that rely on cheap labour. The UK was indeed the workshop of the world, but only declined as other nations copied us. This is normal. The USA's manufacturing industry, for example, is still hyper-competitive to this day. Added to this, Canada and Australia's manufacturing industries are likely to grow as population increases. You could still argue that the Anglosphere economies are as a whole in decline. This certainly does have truth in it, and it's mainly because of mismanagement from the top. However, the decline is way overstated. It looks bad in terms of GDP growth, such as the BRIC nations. But this is a silly way to measure decline. The Kansuk nations and USA are already highly developed nations. It's not that our economies are shrinking, it's that other nations' economies are catching up. Japan, India, China, they aren't doing anything special. They're just experiencing what happened to our nations in the 18th and 19th centuries. We should be instead proud that the world we currently live in is built on and invented by the Anglosphere nations. It is the adventuring, inventive, rebellious and independent culture that is the only thing that makes us special. And these values are by far not in decline. Be sure to check out my other channel, History Sticks, for the complete, longer and comprehensive video.